Good morning. Today we are going to discuss about multi-step synthesis of organic compounds. We know that to synthesize all organic compounds, we have to choose appropriate starting materials. The starting molecule is to be converted to the required product molecule called a target molecule through roots, which will give the optimum yield of the target molecule with a minimum of trouble and time. So, the roots involve the formation of different types of bonds like carbon to carbon bonds, carbon to nitrogen bonds, or carbon to oxygen bonds, etc., or ring closure type reactions, or the introduction of functional groups and their interconversions. And most of the important reactions regarding this have already been discussed in the previous chapters, like reagents and reactions or rearrangements. However, every synthetic route has its characteristic problems. In this chapter, our intention is to find out the starting molecules and the routes through which the target molecules can be synthesized. To do this, we want to work backward, and the process is called synthetic analysis. What do you mean by synthetic analysis? It is a process of stepwise breaking down of the target molecule to available starting materials by disconnection of bonds or groups and functional group interchange, that is represented by FGI. This process gives us the back or reverse steps for the synthesis of the target molecule. However, every disconnected part is the idealized fragment, and it is called a synthon. What is synthon? Synthon is the disconnected part, which is an ideal or imaginary part. We cannot get the synthon straight away from a bottle in the laboratory. Every synthon has its corresponding synthetic equivalents, that is represented by SE, synthetic equivalent. The process of converting one functional group into another functional group is called functional group interchange, FGI. And the process of adding a functional group to a moiety is called a functional group addition, FGA. To understand the process of synthetic analysis and the new terms such as synthon, target molecules, functional group interchange, functional group addition, etc., let us consider the synthesis of phenyl hydroxylamine. That is our target molecule, phenyl hydroxylamine, C6H5NHOH. This is our target molecule. How can you find out its readily available starting material? By the disconnection process. First, if we change the functional group that is functional group interchange. By NO2 we get nitrobenzene, and there is a possibility of disconnection of carbon to nitrogen bond. Then we get 2 parts of the molecule. One is a cationic part and another one is anionic part. Here, consider it is the anionic part and NO2 group is the cationic part. And these disconnected cationic and anionic ionic parts are known as synthones. They are ionic parts of the molecule and which is an imaginary part of the molecule that cannot be, that cannot buy from any laboratory or any industrial field. That is simple imaginary part of the molecule. There will be, of course, its corresponding source of the molecule by which, from which these synthons can be obtained. That is called a synthetic equivalence. The synthetic equivalence of this arenium ion is simply our benzene. Then synthetic equivalence of the NO2 plus cation is our nitrating mixture, that is concentrated nitric acid plus concentrated sulfuric acid. From this source, we can obtain the synthon, that is an electrophile, that is NO2 plus. From this synthetic equivalent, we get this synthon. Okay. Here this arrow stands for a fragmentation, that is disconnection process or functional group interchange or functional group addition process. Then what is the total synthesis of this hydroxylamine from benzene? If we are treating benzene with the nitrating mixture, that is our nitration process, we get nitrobenzene. Nitrobenzene on reduction with zinc and ammonium chloride, it will converted into corresponding hydroxylamine. Then we get phenyl hydroxylamine. That is the total synthesis of the target molecule. Let us discuss the retrosynthesis of cyclohexanol. That is our target molecule, cyclohexanol. Here, it can be disconnected like this, then we get cationic and anionic part of the molecule. That is, this is a cationic part and this is an anionic part. That is, these two fragments are synthons, and these synthons can be obtained from corresponding synthetic equivalents. This cation can be obtained from cyclohexanone, and this is another synthon. Its synthetic equivalent is NaBH4. We know that sodium borohydride is a reducing agent. Here H minus, that is hydride ion, is the nucleophile. So H minus can be obtained from this reducing agent. Then what is the total synthesis of cyclohexanone? By reacting cyclohexanone with the reducing agent sodium borohydride, we get cyclohexanone. Next, we have to discuss about the disconnection of carbon to carbon bonds. It is worth considering a disconnection adjacent to a functional group, especially adjacent to OH and C double bond or functional group. For example, consider this molecule. This is our target molecule. So here first we disconnect the bond adjacent to the OH functional group. That is, we disconnect at this bond, then we get corresponding synthons. What are the synthons? CH3, CH plus OH. This is cationic part, and we get an anionic part, that is CH2 CHO minus. These part, cationic and anionic parts, are collectively called its synthons. Then we have to find out its proper synthetic equivalence. What is the synthetic equivalence of this cation? Its synthetic equivalent is CH3CHO, and its synthetic equivalent is CH3CHO. Then how can you convert these readily available starting materials to our target molecule? We know that these two synthetic equivalents are aldehydes, that is base catalyzed condensation of these two aldehydes will give an aldol, that is CH3 CHOH CH2 CHO. This is our beta hydroxy carbonyl compound, that is our aldol. So this is an aldol condensation reaction. Here the important point to notice that the alpha alcoholic cation, in this case the synthetic equivalent will be an aldehyde. That is, this cationic carbon should possess minimum one hydrogen. Then the synthetic equivalent will be aldehyde. If it is CH3 twice C plus OH, then its synthetic equivalent will be a ketone. Okay. Another point to remember about the cleavage of CC double bond. A CC double bond may be converted to carbon to OH CH before disconnection. For example, if CH2 double bond CH, C double bond O CH3, this is our target molecule. How can you convert into its readily available starting material? First step is functional group interchange. That is, double bond is converted into this saturated bond, that is CH2OH CH2 C double bond O CH3. Then we disconnect the bond adjacent to the OH functional group and we get two synthons. One is CH2OH plus and another one is CH2 C double bond O CH3 minus. These are synthons of this disconnection. And what are the synthetic equivalents? Here we know that this is an alpha cationic alcohol. So the synthetic equivalent of this synthon will be an aldehyde, that is HCHO. That is the synthetic equivalent of this synthon. And here its synthetic equivalent is CH3, C double bond O, CH3. That is a ketone. Then what will be the total synthesis of this compound, target molecule, from these synthetic equivalents? Again, that will be a aldol condensation reaction. Here this is the ketone which is adds to this aldehyde on base catalyzed condensation. It will convert it into aldol type compound, that is beta hydroxy carbonyl compound, that is CH2OH CH2 C double bond O CH3. This will be the product, beta hydroxy carbonyl compound of this aldol condensation reaction, aldol type condensation reaction. Here this is our carbanion component and this is our carbonyl component. In the presence of base, it will deprotonate from this ketone and we get carbanion, that is CH2 minus C double bond O CH3, which on adds to this carbonyl compound and we get this beta hydroxy carbonyl compound. And by heating this compound, water molecule getting eliminated and we get CH2 double bond CHC double bond O CH3. This is our target molecule. Okay. And there is another method, another disconnection method for the cleavage of double bond. That is, it can be done without adding water molecule to the C double bond C part. For example, cleavage of this double bond can be done by famous Wittig reaction, and the corresponding synthons will be ketone and a halide. Phosphorus halide is the nucleophile used in Wittig reaction. CPH3 double bond CH single bond CH3. This halide can attack as a nucleophile to this carbonyl compound and we get our target molecule. This is our Wittig reaction. So the cleavage of double bond can be accomplished by Wittig reaction. Another guidelines for the cleavage of carbon to carbon bond were: the branch point is to be disconnected to get unbranched carbon synthons, which are more likely to be available. For example, CH3, CH2, CH, CH3, CH2, CH2, CH3. If this is our target molecule, how can you cleave near to the branch point? That is, this is the point. Here we cleave and we get synthons like CH3, CH2, CH, CH3 minus and CH2, CH2, CH3 plus. These are the synthons. And these synthons can be obtained from our Gilman reagent or any other organometallic compound. That is, here the carbon having negative charge. So the source of this type of anion will be an organometallic compound. For example, here we take copper containing organometallic compound, that is our Gilman's reagent, CH3, CH2, CH, CH3, twice CuLi, that is our Gilman's reagent, and this is our another synthon, and the source of this synthon will be an alkyl halide because the carbon having positively charged. So its synthetic equivalent will be CH2Br, CH2, CH3. Then what will be the total synthesis of this target molecule? That is, the reaction between this Gilman reagent and alkyl halide. This nucleophile attacks on this carbon and Br getting eliminated and we get this target molecule. That is our famous Corey-House synthesis. Another point is, it is better to disconnect towards the middle of the target molecule rather than cutting off one or two carbon atoms from the end. For example, if we consider target molecule like CH3, CH2, 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 CH3. How can you find its synthons? Here we cleave at the middle of this compound. That is, this carbon to carbon bond can be cleaved. And what will be the synthons? CH3, CH2, CH2 minus and CH2, CH2, CH3 plus. These are the synthons and its corresponding synthetic equivalence will be same as previous example. This will be an organometallic compound like Gilman's reagent. So its synthetic equivalent will be CH3, CH2, CH2 twice CuLi, and its synthetic equivalent will be an alkyl halide like BrCH2, CH2, CH3, and the total synthesis of this reaction will be same, our Corey-lacto synthesis, Corey-house synthesis, not Corey-lacto, Corey-house synthesis. Another point is branches must be disconnected from rings. For example, this is our target molecule C6H5COCH3. How can you cleave this compound? Here the branch will cleave first and we get two synthons, that is, one is our alinium ion C6H5 minus and acyl cation CH3 C double bond O plus, that is our acyl cation. These are the synthons. And what will be their synthetic equivalence? Arenium ion can be obtained from benzene and acyl cation can be obtained from acid chloride. So what will be the total synthesis of this compound? This is an acylation reaction of benzene. Here anhydrous aluminium chloride can be used as a catalyst. Another point is that it is worth disconnecting a carbon to carbon bond between two functional groups separated by not more than three carbons. For example, pH CH2 C double bond O CH pH C double bond O OET. This is our target molecule. How can you cleave this compound? So here we can cleave this compound in this bond and we get two synthons like pH CH2 C double bond O plus and pH CH minus C C double bond O, OET. These are the synthons. How can you obtain these synthons? This is azyl cation. So, synthon synthetic equivalent will be PH, CH2, C double bond O, OET. And here, carbanion, its synthetic equivalent will be PH, CH2, C double bond O, OET. That is, we get the same two esters as our synthetic equivalents. And how can you synthesize this target molecule from these two esters? That is our base catalyzed aldol type condensation reaction. In the presence of base, we get 1,3-diketone. That is a Claisen condensation reaction. Condensation of esters. That's about the cleavage of carbon to carbon bonds. Hope it is clear. Thank you.